Hey, how you doing? This is Little Powerhouse 102. I hope everybody's doing okay. I wasn't gonna do a video today, but I'm gonna talk a little bit about, you know, this Origins line and other He-Man lines, you know. The reason I'm gonna do that is I have two friends, right? They barely started collecting, and they love He-Man. I mean, they like a lot of the vintage stuff. They love the origin stuff that's coming out. You know, it's just they say it's a really cool line to collect right now. It's something that's, like I said, it's popping right now, and you got a lot of choices right now. And they wanted to talk about, you know, the Revelation, you know, cartoon series and the show, you know, on Netflix, you know. And I told them I was going to give my opinion on it. And they're fairly new, you know, with the line, with He-Man. And I could tell you that they got kind of upset with the storyline they gave, you know, in the Netflix series. And, anyways, I wanted to give my opinion, you know. And I know there's a lot of videos out there, a lot of people commenting about that Netflix show, and a lot of people didn't like the storyline. Okay, well, this is my opinion, and after I tell you what I think about it, I'm going to tell you what my friends thought about it. They didn't want to, you know, say nothing on the video, because they're kind of, they're fairly new in all this, you know, collecting hobby and all, and they're kind of shy, you could say. And well, to me, okay, I didn't like the storyline they have for the Netflix, you know, series. The things that I do like is the animation, the images, you know, how the characters look. That looks very awesome. I wish there was a different storyline. I mean, something that us collectors that we've been collecting for so many years, you know, we got upset because of the storyline. But if it would have been something we loved, we would have, you know, I mean, that would be something really awesome to, you know, to have, right? A cool series that we accept that story, but it's not that way, at least for me. Well, talking about the figures they're cool, but they're not, how can I say, I mean, if you collect the classics, I mean, look at Man at Arms here. I mean, this guy is just detailed, you know, everywhere you see him. And you see the Revelations, they're, it's just another option, you know. It has less deco. It has, you know, it's just a different figure, you know. I mean, it's a cool figure, but it's not like the classics. You know, classics is one of the, for me, one of the best lines Master Universe has come up with, you know. And I've seen collectors that have the whole collection, and it's beautiful. You know, it's really, really beautiful line to have. Here we have some of the other Revelation figures. I mean, they're more simpler, less deco, you know. But, you know, it works. I mean, for the price point, you got to admit that they look pretty good, you know. And that's really my opinion. I mean, I really didn't like the storyline. I like the animation, the images, how the heroes looked, you know, except for Teela. Didn't like her look. But other than that, all the other, the heroes, you know, all the other characters, the bad guys, you know, they look very good. It's good, you know. But, you know, if we're talking about, like the 2000X line, you know, here we have Keldor and here we have He-Man. I mean, that 2000X series that they made for He-Man, it was awesome. You know, they had the storylines that, you know, we accepted, and they were really awesome, you know. We had origins, how Skeletor became Skeletor, you know. We have that origin. It's cool. How, you know, the sorceress become sorceress, how Prince Adam became He-Man. I mean, we got storylines in there that they're very, very awesome. Even the Snake Man, you know. We even have King Grayskull, you know, from the creator of He-Man, you could say, you know. You know, so I wish they would have continued to do, you know, more of that 2000X series, you know. But unfortunately, it ended, and it ended, you know, with us wanting more, you know. And Revelations, well, I already gave my opinion. The toys, I really love Masters of the Universe. I mean, I'm going to buy some of the toys. I love He-Man, so I'm not going to buy everything. I'm still waiting on Fisto, Stinkor, and Scareglow. Yeah, I think some of the figures look cool, you know. So, you know, why not buy them, you know? I'm not going to buy everything. I don't know what that line is going to, you know, is going to offer in the future. There might be some cool toys, you know. What I'm not going to buy is the animation, the kids animation Netflix toys. I'm not going to invest into that, because I really don't like them. You know, they're really, they're for kids, you know. I mean, if you're a collector and you have them, cool, good for you. I'm not saying buy them or don't buy them. You know, if you like them, you want to collect them, cool. You know, more power to you. You know, no bad criticism over that or anything like that. You know, it's just about what the collector likes, right? That's just my opinion. Okay, that's my opinion on the Revelations. You know, I'm gonna tell you what my friends said. I mean, like I said, they're fairly new in collecting. And what we did is we started watching, you know, I got all the Filmation cartoons and the series, you know. So we started seeing all the storylines, you know. And so they like the storyline from the Filmation, you know. It's kind of cheesy, but, you know, I mean, it's there, you know. So when they compared it to the Filmation, you know, and the comics and all that stuff, they were kind of confused and kind of upset, you know. And they told me, you know what, I like the origins. They really represent the vintage figures, and, you know, the comics, the Filmation cartoon, but but we're not gonna invest in the new Revelations. I mean, we just don't feel it. We don't feel that those figures or that series is for us, or us to support even their toys, you know. And they're fairly new, like I said, they're fairly new in starting to collect, you know. And me as a collector, you know, I respect that. I mean, if you don't like a product, why open your wallet and start, you know, buying something you really don't appreciate? So I do respect that. And they're both standing their ground. They haven't bought not even a single figure from Revelations. And, you know, it's all good. I mean, it's their opinion. And like I said, they're going to collect what they like. They love the vintage stuff. But the vintage stuff is really expensive. But, you know, they have a few pieces already. And they've been collecting He-Man for a few months. And, you know, they've been having a blast, you know, just like me. And, yeah, guys, I mean, I know everybody has their opinions. And and their likes and dislikes of, you know, of what everything has been coming out, you know. But what I'm saying as a collector and about He-Man, I've been collecting He-Man for a lot of years, and I'm surprised it really surprises me how like my friends are new, these new collectors, my friends, what they think, you know. And I'm thinking maybe that's what's going on with a lot of collectors out there that are new for He-Man, that have been watching the cartoon from the Filmation and the 2000X line, and now they see this, and you know, they just block themselves from buying even the toys, you know. You know, who knows? I mean, maybe that, there's a lot of people out there that think like them, you know. And that's really sad with the writers from Revelations, you know, the directors. Really sad what they did with this He-Man line, because the He-Man line it's just a beautiful line to collect. They could do so many stories, you know, that would be so right for He-Man, that they did the opposite with this Revelations series. I mean, even the kids' animation, you know, has better storylines than the Revelations. Ain't that something? But you know, I mean, just look at the Origins next to the Vintage. They really have that essence. They really have that nostalgic feeling, you know, even when you're holding the figures. I mean, it's really, really great, you know. They did a good job, Mattel, in doing the Origins line. I mean, it's a line that's, like I've been saying, it's accessible. And it's cool, you know. It's like collecting in the 80s. I remember when I was a kid, I used to see all these toys in the shelves, in the pegs. You know, now that I see them, that I'm an older man now, you know, and collecting, it's just awesome to see all this stuff in the stores, you know. So, I mean, there's so many videos out there and opinions of the new Revelations, and they just really messed up the storyline for He-Man. I mean, they really ruined his, you could say his story, you know. And what you gonna do? I mean, as a collectors have been collecting for many years, you know. I seen some videos. They're not even gonna invest money in the new toys, you know. And that's pretty sad. I mean, maybe there's a lot of people out there like that. Maybe there's not. I don't know. I mean, but it really hurts the new collectors that want to start collecting, you know. That they're giving these storylines that you know people do. People, when they get an interest of something, they do their homework. A lot of, you know, I know a lot of people like that, and that's how they start collecting. You know, they love the cartoon. They start looking at, you know, at the history of the toys, the new stuff, the old stuff, like Star Wars. You know, G.I. Joes. You know they start, you know, doing their homework. You know, and they start investing, and it's pretty sad that. We have, I mean, it's a beautiful package, you know, don't get me wrong, something different, you know, the figures are not that bad. I mean, they have a lot of articulation, you know, but it is what it is, guys. You know, I hope I'm not boring anybody here. I mean, I know my videos are kind of different, that what I've been doing here. Right now we're talking about, you know, these lines that we have here representing He-Man, you know. But it's good talk, though. I mean, it's what I think. What, like I said, the new collectors, like my friends here, you know, I hope they do start, you know, doing their videos and sharing their opinions, and that'll be pretty awesome, you know. That'll add to the community. More videos and people, you know, watching more collections out there, you know. I mean, look at this Fisto. I mean, this Fisto's from the classics. He's a beautiful figure, you know, and one of the most expensive figures out there in classics, you know. There's so much detail in these figures, you know. But Origins, I mean, Origins is just a lot of nostalgic, you know, feeling, you know. And when I see these guys at the pegs, when I something new is just, damn, I gotta get them, you know. Like I've told you guys, I have bought triples of probably everything that you guys seen in my videos, you know. And look at it. I still can't get rid of these figures that I have here to display in my wall. You know? That's my drawer right there of Master Universe figures. Look at that. There's another Castle Grayskull there. You know, and I know if you guys already seen, you know, this diorama up here, you know, and wrestlers and all that, so... You know, you guys more or less know what kind of collector I am. You know, I love He-Man. I love everything that represents him. And, but, you know, I really didn't like the Revelation story. And, like, a lot of people didn't like it, you know. Yeah, guys. it's just a lot of awesome stuff that Mattel's giving us. We got this new Revelation stuff, you know. And me, I mean, like, I love He-Man. I'll use a lot of these figures as a filler for my classic, because I didn't have the chance to really, you know, buy all my classic figures. And if I want to start, you know, completing that line, it's just really expensive, you know. But I guess it's a good you could say it's a good investment. I mean, if you sell it one day, you're gonna get your money back, you know. So yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You know, we probably gonna get some questions, some probably kind of maybe even negative critics, but that's okay. This is part of the hobby. Part of being a collector and doing videos, and you gotta accept criticism. You gotta accept the nice comments, everything as it comes. So, you know. So yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I would like to know your opinions too. That'll be pretty awesome to see what you guys think about the new toys that are coming out. Of course, Origins, that's one of the, you know, the figures that it's popping right now. It's very popular right now. And, yeah, guys, it's really cool to talk to you guys and talk about toys. This is what this channel is all about, you know. Hope you guys are having fun this month going shopping for Christmas and spending time with your family. You know, going to the stores and shopping, you know. Hope you guys are enjoying this month like I am, you know. It keeps me going to the store a little bit more and checking out, see if anything's new on the shelf, you know. So that's pretty cool, you know. Yeah, guys. And, yeah, guys, I mean, when I get those new figures in from the mail from Big Bad Toy Store, the Fisto, Scareglow, and Stinkor. You know, I'm gonna share that with you guys. It's the Revelations line. I mean, they look pretty good. You know, those toys look pretty good. So I am gonna share that with you guys and everything else that I get new. You know, this is what this channel is all about. It's about talking about toys, our hobby. How we bought them, how we're gonna get them, you know. And I'm still waiting on my friend that went to California. He's trying to do a deal with the duplicate and the faker, so I hope he does a good deal. He, like I said, he took some stuff from here, and he's gonna try to get that for me. He really hasn't told me anything. I think he has a surprise for me for Christmas, so, you know, that's what I'm just thinking. Really have high hopes. And yeah, guys, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and hope to hear from you guys. And you know, This is Little Powerhouse 102, and I'm out.